drama e nngwe e tlenang jang ke mo lelala le
nngwe le go di pop le ntse le go pop
e tsantse ha ntse
wa tsaki wa
pop he he ma ma ke mo o tsama ne ne ntse go bona a tsama ba tsi
bo bo mati
so sente ba tsus e la ona ga ke ntjola a bi
confident about yourself, whether you are shorty, whether you are slender, stufuza, yellow bone, dark bone, you should feel beautiful about yourself. In everything that you do on a daily basis, you must know that you are good enough. Thank you so much. So I targeted the first topic, we're gonna let it be about the self-esteem. Again, marapile ribua ka self-esteem, ki in if self-esteem. This is just all about how wena uyibonang ka teng. It's about how you value yourself, how you perceive yourself. And you don't just perceive, but it's something that you should believe in. So there are the beliefs and opinions about ourselves. For an example, you may believe wena you are a beautiful woman, you are intelligent, and you deserve happiness. I am good enough. And you must first understand that beauty is not about beauty. There's a certain description of what describes beauty. Do you understand? In any way, because you have to understand that you are unique. If you're gonna come here and tell a woman, but if you didn't put your lashes, you are not beautiful. If that's how you describe beauty, then don't go around to imply beautiful. It's a done deal. So don't go around to plant the negative mentality into making people believe they are less beautiful when they do this. They are more beautiful if they do that. Do you understand? So it's all about that, Betunana. So it's self-esteem. It's all about who's a temper, believing in yourself that you can make proper decisions. Do you understand? Let it be not about who too weak, you know? Now I'm going to come and connect to it, Utina. When cook figure is situation here, low self-esteem, so so at the same time, you have to show love and kindness to yourself. Here we come. What causes low self-esteem? I get it. As a person, you are living amongst people. You are in the community. Toxic. You understand? So definitely there is something that maybe has been said negatively to you, or maybe just by looking at yourself in a mirror you start to feel insecure about how you look sometimes. Do you understand? So being bullied whether by colleagues. Did you know that guys in our working environments, they are bully colleagues? And unfortunately, because you're in the working environment, you can't be always, you know? But sometimes you have to always keep it together. But you can't be bullied by colleagues. For those who are still going to school, our pupils, they can be bullied by learners, you know? That's why we should always pay attention to our children when they come back from school. Tina, we are a generation, Do you know that my five-year-old, the moment she gets into the car, if I'm fetching her after school, she'll be like, but mama, you didn't ask me, Even though she won't be putting the sentence like the way after now, but I'll be getting the point that she says, I didn't pay attention to her today and ask about her day. So that's when I've realized that it's quite important to ask about your child, say, how are you? How was your day? What did you do at school? Show interest in joining Noah so that many praises can come on what she has done. She may tell you that about Joshua something, I just made this artwork, it looked good, and then you praise them. Okay, emotional abuse by parents or our partners. No, that shall not talk about it. We're not doing it. Not physically, but emotionally. You know when somebody hammer you emotionally, he's locking your mind to believe that you are a fool. You cannot do anything for yourself. You are a dumb woman. Even though you cannot think for yourself. Sometimes it's all about the worries, you know, about our bodies. Or maybe your body image and appearance, like I said. Sometimes you can just all of a sudden experience a low self-esteem because the way you look at yourself is like all of a sudden you're no longer appreciating yourself. Ongoing stress, FOMO may be resulted from being cheated on or divorced. Sometimes, start cheating. The first thing that you will start questioning is about you. Is it because maybe I'm too short? Is it because maybe I'm a dark skin? Is it because maybe you start questioning yourself? The fact that you went there, you are wrong. You don't focus on what they've done. You start looking at yourself, and then the moment you look into yourself in that negative manner, you start painting yourself in a wrong manner, and believe at the same time, Ubuti, it's because you are not beautiful enough. You are not attractive enough. Financial issues. Especially amongst men. Abutu wa kamera, give a kidney to you. Also, follow Gaga, into a plastic yaka shop right to control. You start to feel not good enough to be a man. I guess. How can I get home? Banaba Bata the cheese kills. How many cheese kills? Haven't the Babana just replaced the Janga Taga cheese kills because Banaba Jolanga or Nabo Abuti, Lunama Tumahona, the Ken and the cheese kills. You get a little empty-handed.
They do.
You know, don't try to go to the spawn. One of my must knock with the knees and the forehead because it's busy and having the plastics. Hey, this one, those today, they just come empty-handed, guys. Not even a brown bread or maybe those bread with raisins. And then they just come there. The moment they just come there, they say, yo, what is in there? My fully fridge, the pan, I'm an apple, I'm a cheese curd. Men must have manners, but I was not there. I was not user project those feelings to you. It's because that's a full end. So he wants to project those or that emptiness to you, and you will believe it. You know why? Because it's targeting your esteem. And once it targets your esteem, it will affect your mind and it locks your mind. Those who always listen to my lives, I'm sure you've heard me talking about Nkof. Do you understand? An emotional abuser is aimed at controlling. It's all about controlling you most of the times. They control and having power over that person. Negative energy to others. That's why I always say, don't ever take a mental energy. A very negative energy. Because it's meant to lock your mind. It's meant to make you swole. Don't ever. Can't you ever listen to me when I say Hana. Because once you listen to that, you'll forever believe in Ubu.
Yes.
Women in abusive relations tend to change their lifestyle, their appearance, to please their partners. heba fetu. Hasi luna baba kenyang dinefu kankomo. Wanit.
Yeah.
Aki luna baba kenyang dinefu kapunani. Because you want to believe. Traveling is all about pleasing a man. If we are not telling me, how does my mom about some time? Why am I up as a mini corner? Why would I must feel the responsibility to make your pussy tight and grabby? If it's money, let him go to there. Who can I buy when I'm not for my man? So you're protecting yourself because you want to fit. For the in. You change it, take the right size.
Yeah.
So why must you feel when it's your responsibility to change who you are because you're not happy? What about your happiness? Do you understand? I talked about Tunkonfu. Meaning, in other words, this leads to you being blank. Yes, guys, I've lived a life of being abused emotionally. Nobody knows how can you wear. Now we have people who believe that the divorces is because he the failures. Ula wa kena mo ulo ratana limuna wo mo lewa lewa uwa. Juba sana sidi ki jeso ubuwa uge, don't confia uge. It's because she's a failure, it's because she can't keep a man, it's because she talk too much. There's no man who can stand a woman who talks like this. Ah, Tina, we are not zombies. No, we're not being zombies. There are men out there, like I was saying in my life, there are men out there, they want to make you believe that a Toyota Corolla, it has 5 wheels. Even though you have it has 4 wheels. So you're not supposed to challenge him and say, hey, baby, there are 4 wheels. The moment you say there are 4 wheels, hey, you think you're clever, you want to control a man must be dominant. Ah, a man must be intellectual.
Exactly.
Then we'll go forward, and it is okay to be unique. We never have that uniqueness, after all. When you are unique, you don't push him into someone. Have a man will understand that my woman is a person who understands it, and she wants things to be addressed this way. In my relationship, I almost dumped him recently. This one has disappeared for a day. Not really disappeared, but I'm calling him. He's not taking my calls. When he comes back, he says, I got a much older defunder. Sit at my work so easily. I want to wait for you until you come down. Come down, my ass. Thou shalt explain where have you been. Why have you not been taking my calls? I'm not gonna push. I'm the one who is hurt here, so I'm not gonna do things according to how and how you want. You don't love me. Take responsibility when you've messed up in a marriage, in a friendship, calling yellow. Be upfront. When somebody says you've ruined their feelings or maybe their emotions by doing this, take accountability. You cannot be in any type of a relationship, whether it's family relationship, intimate relationship, or friendship, whereby a friendship who cannot even take accountability of what they've done. Why more one of them must have the maybe do things according to how they want? And when they are happy, when they are not happy, for the sake of lasting in a marriage, so that these attitudes of saying you are a failure, they don't come over you. So when you forget, you continue to die inside and not if you don't express it. So I was like, you know what, Buti? It's either you explain right now. If you don't explain right now, once I press red button here on this phone, this relationship is over. Can you tell me, I'm still waiting for you to come down? Come down in when? Because if you're waiting for me to come down, by the time you come back, I'll be 10 times angrier. I'll be red now. I'll be a fire. You understand? So it's all about having the relationships whereby we can account and we change this attitude. This societal explanation, because she cannot keep her man. Do you know what happened in that marriage? These are the societal expectations that we try by all means to destroy this negative attitudes. We are trying to destroy them in these conferences so that when we walk out there, we treat an individual as a unique being and you don't know where that person is coming from and I'm the way a guy. So you cannot predict someone's life. Everywhere you go, make sure you plant positivity. So in everything that had happened, emotional stress and everything, I'm sure we've dealt with a lot of issues, personal issues. These are the main things that make you lose your self-esteem. Now, this is the only skill that can take you to the future. A skill of being resilient. Resilience can be explained as the ability to bounce back. That's how I describe it. Have you seen the gutter? The gutter, when you stretch it, will check that these are the life circumstances. You're experiencing the pain, you're going through everything. When you let go of that rubber, it goes back to where it was. That's how you should always bounce back after each and every life challenge. Don't stay there. Don't stay there because you're going to end up in COVID. Do you understand? So you are able to bounce back after having experienced life challenges, different life challenges, of course. With strong resilience skills, you can handle disappointments. Come on, me guys, me, I'm always ready. Hey, nobody can just, hey, me, I'm ready, shame. What do you mean by that? It's just a matter of getting the clarity before I take the decision. So that I don't fire, maybe I just misread this person. I want to get you, you just say I'm ugly or what? What do you mean about that? You know, I just made you go, Flexibility, responsibility. Sometimes just because life has been hard on you, it doesn't mean you would sit back and cry forever that, hey, life has been so bad. You take responsibility of your life so that is one. I also included independence. You know, sometimes when you're in the process of bouncing back, yes, we may be there in terms of support system and everything, but you may not always be responsible for your total bounce back. That is your responsibility alone. Do you understand? Even if I can preach and preach, if you're not ready to come out of that uncomfortable corner, you'll never bounce back until you say, I want to be myself again. Self-awareness, I already talked about that. Problem-solving skills. Be self-aware. When you're being self-aware, you jot down everything that is about you. You don't understand what it is that you don't like. What is it that you don't tolerate? What is it that is a bit? You know, note, you cannot achieve this without being optimistic. There is always something positive that comes out of an unpleasant circumstance. Yeah, you understand? Because I started asking myself, how many women are being belittled, their self-confidence is being crushed. Some of them, they committed suicide after being cheated on. Some, they couldn't be resilient on time. They lost their lives in the process. Actually, how many oppressed women out there? What are the challenges that they're expressing out there? Because I've experienced that, and by profession, I'm a social worker, I see these things, and most of them, I've experienced them. Then I was like, let me just open this blog. Let people know what's going on out there. Thank you to all the followers and supporters of Keep Moving that they went to. Okay. Sendia Vala. Now, don't compromise. Me, I was once a fool, guys.